Good morning, Eagles. I'm Marissa.
And I'm Courtney.
Here's a special on this year's International Festival.
Hi, I'm Elizabeth Dundee.
Hi, I'm Marvel the Marvelous.
As you know, International Festival is fast approaching. The tables that have signed up are Puerto Rico, England, Ireland, Scotland, Philippines, Nigeria, India, African continent, ancient Rome, Hawaii, Polynesia, Russia, Caribbean West Indies, and Israel.
And the tables that we are expecting haven't contacted Ms. Justy. These tables are Voz Latina, Mexico, Japan, Brazil, and the Middle East.
To sign up for a table, go to Ms. Justy's room in 118E, and the deadline is March 22nd. Time is running out, sign up now.
The International Festival is not only a fun event, it's also great for community service hours. So if you're searching for community service hours, please contact Ms. Justy in room 118E or email her at sally.justy@cobbk12.org.
Remember, deadline is March 22nd. This year, Marvelyn and I decided to have an all-Caribbean West Indies table instead of separate islands. So if you're from the Caribbean West Indies and would like to join or help us out in the festival,
please contact Ms. Mitchell in room 213 or email her at barbara.mitchell@cobbk12.org.
Also, there will be dancing involved. So if you would like to dance for the Caribbean West Indies Islands, I'm the dance director. If you're interested, stop by Ms. Mitchell in room 213 and give her your information, and I'll contact you as soon as possible.
Here are some clips of the previous international festivals. If you like what you saw, then remember to visit Ms. Justy in room 118E and sign up for a table.
Remember, deadline is March 22nd. This is a fun opportunity that you don't want to miss.
Thank you, and hope to see you there.
Sign up for a table for the International Festival in room 118E. The deadline is March 22nd. FBLA will host their annual resume day on Wednesday, February 13th at 3:40 in room A203. Come out and get help creating your resume. In observance of National Professional Counselors Week, we would like to say thank you to all of our South Cobb counselors.
STCLA will be selling cake pops next Wednesday and Thursday.
Eagle TV asked some of our teachers the difference between school then and now.
Between school today and when I was in school, number one is discipline. Discipline has let up, I believe, some in school. And it was more structured when I was in school as well. Also, school spirit. We had a whole lot more school spirit. You didn't have kids roaming the hall with other school t-shirts and sweatshirts and jackets on. Everyone believed and supported their own school.
When I was in elementary school, not going to tell you what year, but they still used the paddle for disciplinary infractions, and you got a certain amount of whacks for each type of discipline. In gym, we still had to wear uniforms, these cute little things that zipped up in the front and everybody looked alike. No cell phones, so forget it. You had a dime to go call in the payphone, and let's see. Oh, movies weren't videos. They were reel-to-reel movies, and the teacher had to actually go to class to learn how to use the equipment. So it's very different. Quieter. I don't seem to think it was quite as loud, but maybe it's because I'm old.
Push it real good. Here's an interview with our top wrestlers in an ROTC feature.
We both won fourth place at our area tournament, which was held at North Cobb High School this year. And we will be able to continue to sectionals this weekend, coming Friday and Saturday, at Kennesaw Mountain High School. It feels good knowing that I have another chance to go to states this year and make my mom and my teammates proud and my coaches. And, yeah.
This is my first time going. Last year I got hurt,
So I had a good chance last year, but I couldn't go. So this is my first, and I'm just happy to represent the school and my teammates and coaches and my mom. Yeah.
The competition I competed in was a drill meet at Osborne High School. It was a lot of schools there, and we went out, we competed, we gave our best. We came back with 2 trophies, second place in armed male mixed platoon and third place in unarmed male mixed squad. This is very important for me because I've been in the JRTC program for 4 years and I have been on the drill team for 4 years, but this is my first year as drill team commander. And I'm the type of person who would like to teach everybody what I know. And what I have taught the drill team will hopefully continue on and improve.
I'm Siri.
I'm Naya.
I'm Joey.
It's basically like a leadership club where we come to hone our skills. Most of us participate in like different competitions. Like I participated in a prepared speech. She did CSI investigation. She did fingerprinting. It's like what we like know what we want to do and we're pursuing basically.
It felt great to win first place in CSI, basically because I got to open an actual crime scene, collect hair and wet hair from a crime scene. And it showed me all the skills that I can actually do in a competition, and to be first place is great.
It feels good because it was a lot of people who competed for the same thing, and it's kind of like I basically showed that I can do better than who was there.
Here are some of South Cobb's teachers' top favorite songs of all time.
Hi, I'm Raven.
Your boy Red in the building.
Your boy Mark.
Shaheen.
And we're from Eagle TV Music and More. This week is Teacher Throwback Week.
Throwback!
Here are your top 5 teacher throwbacks for this week.
This is Coach Snyder, and I chose an old school song by Neil Young, 1971. You can see it live on YouTube. I chose Old Man.
South Cobb, my name's Miss Nevels, and one of my favorite songs of all time is Ozzy Osbourne's Crazy Train.
My name is Miss Epperson, and my favorite song of all time is Floss by Coldplay.
Tides that I tried to swim against.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Thompson, and my favorite song of all time is Luther Vandross, If This World Were Mine.
I would place at your feet all that I own. You've been so good to me. If this world were mine, I'd give you the flowers.
Hi, my name is Miss Addis, and my favorite song of all times is Whitney Houston, I Want to Dance with Somebody.
Here's this week's short film.
There's something on your face! It was pain!
Now, son, don't touch that cactus.
You're dead to me.
Sir, you seem to have a severe case of baby voice. Honey, why is the baby on fire?
Buy me more jewelry!
I'm wondering if my pony can fly.
Huh.
And now, ducks.
I was just about to say that.
Are you serious?
Totally.
Oh, that's spooky.
We are so in sync.
Here's some highlights from last Friday and Tuesday's games against Kennesaw Mountain and Hillgrove. Congratulations to Chris Simon, Ryan Sumner, Terrence Wells, Guy Shepherd, Niles Hamilton, Jeremiah Alphabet, Chauncey Ingram, and Stefan Masha, who all signed to play football in college.
Join us tonight for our senior night and last home game of the season against the Harrison Hoyas.
Varsity girls at 6 and boys at 7:30.
Here are Devontae and Jamar with our Eagle TV Sports Corner.
What's going on? I'm Devontae.
I'm Jamar.
And this is Eagle TV Sports Corner. Go ahead and start off by saying the NFL has come to a close with the Super Bowl. Ravens won 34-31 over the 49ers. You know, it was a close game. Everybody fought hard, but, you know, the Ravens just came out on top. All right, now that we're done with the NFL, we're going to go ahead and transition to the NBA. What we got, Jamar?
First matchup, we got the Clippers versus Miami, 8 o'clock, ESPN. Next, we have Portland versus Houston, 8 o'clock. Phoenix versus OKC, 8 o'clock. New York Knicks versus Minnesota. And we have the last matchup, Chicago Bulls versus Utah Jazz, 10:30 ESPN.
Well, there's your NBA matchups. We'll get back to you next week. I'm Devontae. That's Jamar, Sports Corner.
Remember, if you have any Eagle TV requests, email us at eagletvshs@gmail.com
or follow us on Twitter at eagletvshs. I'm Marissa.
And I'm Courtney.
Have a great day.